raising your motherfucking voice and coming through here, jerking these little kids around like marionette motherfucking strings. Let me explain something to you. I control this environment. You're in Harlem, friend. You're uptown. Nothing happens in this motherfucker without my say-so. Nothing happens in this motherfucker without my word go. You don't breathe, motherfucker, until I say what time it is to breathe.
Look in these eyes, son. Do you see fear in these eyes? I'm not afraid of you or your little punk-ass gang.
Let me tell you something. The devil is a personal friend of mine. He rides with me every day of my life. Suggestion for you is to deal with these people with the utmost respect. If you can't handle that, if that's a fucking problem, because you know I'm a very nice guy, but you've been raising your motherfucking voice just a little too motherfucking much. And I'm gonna ask you this one time and one time nicely. You've been disrespecting my people, treating these bitches like they're fucking dogs. If you have any respect for humanity, not just these individual people, you'll deal with people in a way that they can handle the situation. Now, I've been real nice to you, and I don't know how much fucking longer I'm gonna be fucking nice to you.
You don't like being nice to me? Get the fuck out of my office.
You know what? I'm gonna let you live today.
Whoopee, big man.
Coming up in the ghetto is not an easy thing. The devil lurks at every corner, you know. There's a lot of temptation. See, most of the kids in the rave scene, you know, they're suburban kids. They're used to different type of temptation. See, I'm from 135th in Lenox. The temptation is direct and in your face, you know. You have to fight for everything you get. You know, if you're not down for making it happen, if you a sucker, if you a bitch, if you a bitch ass nigga, you know, your life will be over. It's a constant struggle. It's a constant fight, you know? That's why we hold on to family so doggedly. That's why we're so determined, you know? If I don't fight for what's mine, if I allow my family to be abused, if I let you come in and violate my people, people who work for me, they my family. If you try to violate them, that's like you violating me. You know, and if you violate me, first time I'm gonna tell you not to do it. The next time I'm gonna have to murder you. You know, it's nothing personal. It's only business, baby. It's only business. You know. My father was the most ruthless drug dealer Harlem ever knew. One day he just disappeared. I didn't want that to be me. I didn't want to have niggas praising my name and in the next wondering where the fuck ever happened to Nicky Barnes. So this version of Nicky Barnes, this young Nicky Barnes, was not going to disappear. I was not going to be just a memory in people's mind, a thought in people's mind. My destiny is to live forever.
Excuse me, where's Kim Shepherd? She went inside to see the doctor. She's been there for a while. All right, whatever. I'll find out for myself. Fuck you very much.
Did this to you, fucking asshole! Fuck you, you self-righteous fucking bastard!
What's the matter? What did they tell you?
You did this to me! You killed me, you self-righteous bastard! Fuck you!
she, huh?
You're killing me.
What, she's going crazy.
Give me a fucking death sentence, Nicky.
Stop it.
Nicky.
What's up? You look like you got something to say.
Nicky, I made you go.
You did what?
I made you go, Nicky. I made you go.
What
okay?
Do you mean you made you go? What the fuck is that?
I made you go. I set it up. I set it up so you get the lettuce.
So what are you saying to me?
What's wrong with you?
What are you saying to me? What are you saying to
me? I fucking have it, Nicky!
Did you have your drink, Mom?
Yeah. I had my drink.
So?
I...
Look, you should support this kid. He's going through enough.
You know what?
I know I'm not one to tell you how to run your family, but...
You're right.
I have been taking care of your family, one member of your family, for the last 18 months, so I feel I do have the place to say...
That's okay.
He's in a bad situation.
That's your way of taking care of him. Putting him into this nice, wonderful, bad situation of clubs and drugs and HIV positive?
Well, something in this house was obviously going incorrectly that forced him out to begin with. There would be no Nicky if there was you doing everything correctly.
Look, Ma, if you got something to say, you know, just fucking say it.
What?
Just say it. What is it that you want
to
say?
What I want to say to you, I can't deal with this right now. I have to talk to your dad. I can't make this decision all by myself.
What do you
mean? You just came in with this whole story about wanting to come home and you clean up your act and go back to school.
Gee whiz, Ma, you know.
I can't decide right now. I need some time.
I should have fucking known, you know. For once, if you could just stop being such a selfish bitch and think about me once.
Oh, shit.
Oh, it's child abuse.
You know what, guys?
I am
We're
not...
fucking out of here.
You're not leaving.
No,
listen to me.
Don't fucking ever put your hands on me again. That's the last time.
Look.
I told you, I can't. I want you to come back. I can't think about this right now, for God's sake. And
look, you're fucking kid.
I don't want to talk to you.
You gotta talk to
me
right now.
I don't want to hear from you.
Look, your kid is in a desperate situation. Look, I know I'm not perfect, and I know I do things wrong, but he needs
you.
You're gonna fucking put your head in the sand.
I'm not listening.
This is not adult.
Why don't you please just go?
Yo, fuck this, man. You know what? It was nice knowing you.
Your kid has AIDS.
I told you.
He has AIDS. Are you going to try to help him or what?
Thanks for everything, Ma.
I'm not talking
Appreciate
to you.
Appreciate it.
Can you come back?
Really?
Look, I'm not a devil. The kid has AIDS. He needs your help.
And how
He's reaching
he get
out
that?
To you.
And how
He's
did he get that?
Because something was wrong in this house, and he felt the need
no,
to have to leave.
Don't do that to me. Don't do that to
me. I'm not saying you gave him AIDS, but I'm saying you caused him to be in this situation.
I didn't cause him to go to you. He's the one who left the house. You're the one that turned him into a druggie who now is probably going to lose his life. It's all on your head, not mine.
Well, something you or your husband did got him into homosexuality.
Oh,
maybe you should talk to your husband and find out what he's doing when you're asleep.
You know what? Get out of my house.
It
now,
doesn't have to be
leave.
Like this.
It, you know what? Leave.
Why don't you care for your son? If he would have gotten hit by a car and broken leg, you wouldn't have a problem caring to his needs. This is the same thing. This is the
drugs
same thing.
Drugs and broken bones are not the same thing.
Drugs are an illness. Drug abuse is a disease.
What about disease?
She isn't fucking
She's got disease.
Man. You know what, Ma? I would have laid down in the fucking street for you and let a car run over me.
Oh, really?
For you, yes.
Oh, really? And you, what, you wouldn't do it
this
now?
This is your decision. This is your decision. Just
my decision
that.
Is that I need
just
time
know
to
that
think
shit.
About this. That's all I'm telling
no,
you. I need
this
time
is your blood.
To think about
He's
it.
He's your blood.
You know,
he is your blood.
You
and you're letting your
and
blood.
Have them go.
If they leave, I'm leaving with them.
How can you, how can you do this to
that.
Your own blood?
I'm not doing
this
anything.
This is your decision,
Ma. I just said.
Thanks for the help. Maybe I'll call you again sometime.